The coronavirus pandemic's disruption of the educational system has raised concerns over widening learning gaps among youth. At the same time, the crisis has presented a unique opportunity to rethink and revitalize the educational system. This according to Eli Hurvitz, executive director of the Trump Family Foundation. He'll be presenting, along with Dalit Stauber, former director general of the education ministry, a new model for successful reform in education. This at the Eli Hurvitz Conference on Economy and Society, currently taking place this week at the Israel Democracy Institute. He spoke earlier with us.
Our session this coming Tuesday at the conference, together with the Minister of Education, the heads of the teacher unions, and of course with experts on education from Israel and abroad, comes in a very timely manner, because we understand that the pandemic, the crisis, is nearing its end. Vaccines are already approved for admission, and the challenges for education are enormous, but also the opportunities. There are some opportunities that are for once in a lifetime. We all understand, and it's not a surprise, that our education system is not in good shape now following the crisis. These were very, very long months, which teachers stretched beyond possible. They were pressured from all over, and education sort of encapsulated into a very basic package. Now everyone is exhausted. So the gaps, as you said, are widened. The intellectual gaps, learning gaps, and also socially and emotionally. And in Israel, to start with, our gaps between students, you know, Jews and Arabs, residents of the center and the periphery, are now further increased. So we need a great plan now that will be available to teachers and students to provide them with resources, but also with the public trust that they all need. So the opportunity at hand now, and that's the heart of the thing, is that the crisis also uncovered gaps that entail an opportunity. For instance, there's a gap between what is traditionally taught in school and the real world around us. Schools were created in the Industrial Revolution era, so we force kids to come every morning to sit quietly and listen. The teacher dictates on the blackboard, they copy, then they try to memorize, you know. But the minute they moved to a home-based learning environment during the lockdown, all of these external routines evaporated, vanished, and they had to organize by themselves. So they needed to become highly motivated, self-learners, so to speak, and they had to study alone and in groups. They needed to reason their arguments, to think critically, to be creative, to use technology. And suddenly these skills that now students practice for learning are the same skills that their parents use in their 21st century workplace. So we know it's boring for kids in school, and we keep on sending them. Nostalgia is a big driving force for humanity. So we want our lives back, and we want our schools to return to normal. But I'm sure that as much as we will not be happy with standing in traffic, in a traffic jam for 2 hours, in line for a meeting, our children at the same time will not be enthusiastic about sitting in a boring classroom. So now there is an opportunity to reimagine education. And it's not only in Israel, it's all around the world, to capture the opportunity and to make education much more relevant to the lives of our children. The gaps are enormous, and the challenges are even bigger than before. So it's part of our social contract with them. We need to secure their future. So we will come, everyone together. Education is not something that one player could lead and perform by themselves. You need a big partnership, a collaboration. And this is where the study that was prepared by the Israel Democracy Institute is so important, because there are best practices. and success stories. Even in Israel, there were attempts that were highly successful to move education forward. And we should learn not only from disadvantages, but we can pinpoint our efforts into what has been successful in Israel and to learn from our own experience.
So can you elaborate perhaps on some of those examples where rethinking and reimagining teaching was able to show promise and potential from this model?
Sure. So when you were looking at what extraordinary teachers were doing, even through this crisis, you saw teachers not freezing, not copying and pasting their in-school classroom practice into the Zoom application. Rather than they used the small groups, even with less hours of teaching, and they took a courageous professional judgment. They decided to prefer quality over quantity. Instead of sufficing with the shallow waters of collecting information from the textbook and preparing for a test only to forget what you had learned the week before, they took the time and the effort to deep dive into the more important stuff, to encourage thinking and understanding and application, and it worked for them. We tried this in Israel in the past decade, for instance, in the advanced levels of mathematics studies in high school, what is titled 5 units in mathematics. Israel elevated the level of studies in mathematics 10 years ago, and one of the results was that the trajectory turned negative because it became very, very difficult. But in an effort relying mostly on teachers, on the great teachers we have for mathematics, giving them the conditions, the time, they need time, and the environment that was required, with support from high tech, from the Ministry of Education, from local authorities, from school networks, the universities, everyone around the same table on board, aligning their efforts in the same direction to reverse the negative trajectory and to create a leapfrogging onwards. And it was a success. When you give teachers trust and conditions and everyone is aligned around the same goal, it is possible. Israel doubled the number of its 5-unit graduates in mathematics over a period of less than 10 years, dramatic improvement because capacity was built in advance, agreement was created between all stakeholders, and then policy came on board with the energy and spirit and with the policy that was so required, and success arrived. And it's also possible when we look at the system today, much more difficult, much overwhelming effort is needed, but it is possible, and there's a proof of concept that is feasible, and that great people in education just need to sit around the same table and agree on a shared vision and a roadmap to realize it. You can see from other countries around the world that it is possible, but also from Israel.
Eli Hurvitz, Executive Director of the Trump Family Foundation, on the education model to be presented this week at the Israel Democracy Institute's Conference on Economy and Society.